it's your old friend Oxo, come back again for another Ruby reaction. That's right, we're back to Ruby. Yeah, Ruby, I'm so glad to see you again. So it looks like we got some Genlock right here at the beginning, so I'm super excited about this. So Ruby was getting kind of interesting. Well, it's always been interesting to me, but I mean, it's getting more. We're getting a lot of flow with this particular season. I am enjoying where it's kind of going. So far, so good. I have no complaints. This is actually going to probably get up there close to, probably toppling over my season four. Because as I had it, I had season, two, three, I believe it's 2, 3, 1. And then 4, 5 could go either way. I think 5 was still at my bottom. But this one could probably take out number 4 spot for me, being kind of right there in the middle as far as one of my favorite seasons so far. So kudos to Rooster Teeth for already establishing a great season so far. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they do. We got where Jean kind of had a very physical reaction with Osmond's basically the truth of everything, and he was not very happy, and he basically kind of came at Oscar really hardcore. So, and I get it, he felt like that maybe the sacrifices that were made, especially with Pyrrha, weren't really justified, that even if the maiden was there, that particular instance would not make any headway. Even if the maiden had survived, even if Pyrrha did take the powers or whatnot, that her sacrifice, while Pyrrha felt like it was a good sacrifice, John still not so much, because he cared so much about Pyrrha, and then he found out that she truly loved him, and that was kind of hard for him. So I get the reason why he was mad, and then Oscar runs away. So it is very interesting, and we get a really cool cute couple with John's sister and her wife, and that's cool. I love that aspect of it. And then we get these two military dudes and this short old lady that's fighting with Maria, and they just kind of just like two little titans. I want to just see them just start clashing with each other. It's just so funny with that. So I'm looking forward to seeing what this episode has, so let's get to it.
This is how the war begins.
Oh, okay.
All wings engage. Interceptors 3 and 4 take bogeys 2 o'clock, Angel 6.
Round, do you see that?
I see it.
Contact, hostile net attack.
Shit.
Still your cockpits, you're not engaged.
This is not a skirmish. This is not airspace confusion. This is not a terrorist action. This is it. The Union's making their play.
Oh, wow. Yes, the 26th. I'm so super excited, but we're gonna be on that the next week. Stay close, but no less. Hope is that was so cool. I still think that's the coolest part about this episode. Let's see what we got. Sounds like Trinity. Oh, Emerald.
I hate being kept in the dark like this.
Yeah, Cinder was a pain, but at least she kept us filled in.
Can I ask you something?
You're gonna.
Yeah.
Why did you come with us? The night Cinder and I found you.
Why are you asking?
Just answer the question.
Just made sense.
Yeah. It made sense.
All my life, my father trained me to be a killer, an assassin like him. And then moments after I killed him, you two showed up looking for someone with my exact skills. Just felt like it was meant to be.
That's it?
Hey, what's your problem?
I mean, there has to be something you want from this, right?
True.
Salem's promised us everything. We win this thing for her, we'll be top dogs in her new world. What more do you want?
I just... Cinder was the only family I ever had.
Wow.
She cared about me, taught me things. But without her here, I don't know if what we're doing...
Wake up already. Cinder doesn't care about you. She doesn't care about either of us.
You don't know what you're talking about.
You're in denial.
Yeah.
But if you're gonna start having a crisis of identity or some crap, get me out of it.
Oh, wow.
I'm sorry you didn't have a mommy that loved you, but I had a father who hated me. He never went easy on me. Every day of training was a beating. And when I unlocked my semblance, he stole it with his. This is a crutch. This makes you weak. He told me I could have it back when I was strong. So I got strong. But I never got it back. I've had to work harder than anyone to get where I am. You may not like it here without Cinder, but I think I'm right where I'm supposed to be.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yes, the world is mean, and I'm a big bad man now, just like the others.
How long have you been standing there?
All you ever learned was pain and violence, and now you're too afraid to leave it. Such a tragedy.
You don't know me.
You don't know me.
Hey!
Shh. I want to tell you both a little secret. Your question is all wrong.
What?
What do you want from this? Children, please. If you're not loving what you're doing, then you're in the wrong field.
So okay. What? Are you saying we should just leave?
No. You can't do that.
Then what did you come here for?
To say farewell. There's been a change in plans. Her Grace must act swiftly if we are to prevail. If General Ironwood comes to his senses and calls upon aid from Vacuo, all may be lost for us. And so the good doctor and I are being sent to Atlas to prepare.
Prepare for what?
Tyrion!
Huh.
It's time.
Prepare for what? Yeah, exactly. Prepare for what?
Do what makes you happy, children. Please. I'm begging you.
That guy is extremely creepy. Okay.
Oscar!
Oscar!
The city's enormous.
Yeah.
He could have gone anywhere.
This is all my fault. I overreacted.
I still don't really understand what happened. Was it about the mission?
It's kind of hard to talk about.
I know. Top secret. Did he do something wrong?
No, he didn't. We just got some new information, and it's going to be a lot harder than we thought.
I mean, if it was easy, then it wouldn't be important, right?
I think we're all just a bit unsure of what to do next.
You could stay in Mistral. get your licenses at Haven, and come back to Argus. There's a lot of good you can do here. I know your mission is important, but it's not like you're the only ones who can do it. It's not the only mission that needs doing.
Yeah.
It's not that simple.
But, yeah, yeah.
Well,
it's not that simple.
I should go pick up Adrian from daycare. Yeah. I'll let Tara know what's happened, and we'll meet you later. Good luck.
Hold on, I'm gonna do a brief pause. Again, the whole, you can feel it a little bit right here. Apathy, again. It's like the whole underlying tone of this season so far is there's apathetic points that you could go, this sounds like an easier path. Why don't I do that? And while, yes, as a fan of Ruby, and I want to see our folks do wondrous things, and I want to see Sean kick, I want to see all of them kick their, but I want to see all of them kick their butts, and it's just like, it's so funny that they are so driven, and I'm glad to see this driven, because of Pyrrha. That just makes it so, I love it, sorry.
Hey, there's a cafe over there. Why don't we get something to warm up?
I'm okay. You two go on ahead.
Okay.
You don't want anything?
We'll be right back.
Okay. Sean, don't be mopey. Okay. The leaf is guiding them somewhere. Where are you leading me, leaf?
Once, like a dream, you looked at me and everything fell.
Is Pyrrha from here? My gosh.
Some people fall in love for life. Others never get it right.
I guess they did.
One thing that I know for sure. Longer than a life.
It's really beautiful, isn't it?
Who's that?
Yeah. Why here?
She trained here.
Oh!
Sanctum Academy.
That's
Everyone
right.
Everyone was crushed when she chose Beacon over Haven. No one wanted to see her go, but it was where she wanted to be. I'm just glad she was surrounded by such amazing people.
She should be standing here.
She is. She understood that she had a responsibility to try. I don't think she would regret her choice, because a Huntress would understand that there really wasn't a choice to make. And a Huntress is what she always wanted to be.
Pyrrha never got the chance to graduate, but she was a Huntress.
Thank you.
John?
Was that his imagination? Like, who was that? She looked just like Pyrrha with just shorter hair.
Why did you?
I'm sorry. I've been a terrible leader. And a terrible friend, and I...
John, this has to stop.
We heard what you said to Cinder at Haven. You're not being fair to yourself. We love you, just like we loved Pyrrha. We're teammates. Family.
We don't want to lose you two.
Yeah.
I think she knew she wasn't going to win. That she might not come out alive. But she also knew she was the only one that could try.
So she did.
So she did.
Maybe we should too.
Yeah, we should.
Pyrrha may not be by our side anymore. But we can fight like she is.
Then in a way, she will be.
We should check back in at the house. Come on.
Oh, Rooster Teeth. You. Oh.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pyrrha. That's a beautiful statue. I love the leaf. I think that was during season 3.
I've never seen him this bad.
Oh.
Come on, let's get him up.
Why am I on the stairs?
Probably because no one's home, Uncle Crow. We've been out looking for Oscar.
Oscar?
Hey,
I'm sure this looks great to the neighbors.
No luck?
No. You?
Don't worry. We aren't going to Atlas without him.
We?
Sorry we won't be staying.
No, you're not.
How about we get out of the cold?
Oh, huh? I was wondering when you'd get back.
Oh, wow. It looks amazing. I love that.
I was worried sick. Are you okay?
What are you wearing?
Is something cooking?
Oh, yeah, I thought maybe you guys would appreciate a hot meal after spending all day looking for me, apparently.
It's my fault we were all out there in the first place. Oscar, I am so sorry for earlier. I was way, way out of line, and what I said...
No, it's okay. These past few days, I've been scared of the same things you were. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be me, but I did some thinking, and I do know that I want to do everything I can to help with whatever time I have left.
Good. This team isn't the same without you, Oscar.
Yeah.
The casserole!
We're on it, Chef.
combat gear looks good.
Yeah.
Where are you going now?
I don't want to get in the way of your celebration.
You've been gone all day. Just sit with us.
Look, Ruby, I'm glad you kids worked out, whatever all that was. But the fact is, we're not a single step closer to Atlas.
Actually, I think I have an idea.
Okay.
But it's sort of a no going back kind of idea.
Well,
okay.
Let's hear it.
With Cordo on watch, only Atlas airships have the clearance to leave for Solitas. So, we steal an Atlas airship.
That's not just breaking the law. That's definitely worse.
How would we even get onto the airfield?
That part I haven't quite figured out yet. But I was...
Okay, stop. Just stop. Look, if this thing goes south, it's not something we can just fight our way out of. This is the Atlas military we're talking about. For your sake, Just drop this.
Come on, Crow.
I want to hear him out.
Ruby.
I want to hear him out. I know you're trying to protect us, that you're afraid we can't do it, but right now, I don't really care what you think.
Okay.
Just because you don't have an idea doesn't mean we're out of options. Oz hasn't been here to tell us what to do, but we still managed to get this far anyway. We've been in bad situations before, and we didn't need an adult to come save us or tell us what to do.
Right.
We just did it our way. And I say we do it our way.
Yeah. Yes!
And if you think you can keep up with us kids, we'd be happy to have you.
Looks like you didn't give her enough credit either.
Ruby looks determined. Oh my god. Oh, you hurt your teeth. Oh god. Oh, that was so beautiful. Oh my gosh. Oh, Pyrrha. I was literally talking about Pyrrha this before. Oh my gosh. It's just, I guess it was meant to be. I didn't even know this episode had her or had the statue or anything. I did not even know. I was just going over everything that Jean was going over because this is why he's mad, this is why he's upset, and blah, 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 blah. And then we were talking about it. And then, bam, right in the sucker punch. I guess that's the whole point, is that they wanted you to kind of get why he was so angry in the first place to get that's so perfect. To, you know, everyone going, hey, let's talk about Pyrrha. And then, bam, right there in the face, you get Pyrrha. Well, not literally Pyrrha, but a statue and a lady that looks a lot like Pyrrha and sounded like Pyrrha. I wonder if that was her voice actress. I'm going to play it for a second. I'm trying to let it play for a second. Oh, so pretty. Okay, Emerald, Mercury, Tyrion, Arthur, Jean, Nora, and okay. Redheaded woman. Yes! Yes! I knew it! Jim Brown! Yes! Okay. Redheaded woman was up here. It was like a, I don't know what that was, like a ghost or what that was, but that was beautiful. That was really beautiful. And I'm so glad to see all this. Man, I don't know what else to say about this particular season. It's just been so, so, so good. But I do see the underlying tone of just, you know, the back and forth, the weight that they have to carry, and that whole, you know, apathy was such a big thing on that, you know, with a couple episodes ago. And we see it continue on a little bit because we're presented as honest, and then the kids are presented, well, not even kids anymore, the group is presented with alternate paths that they could literally take, and anyone in anyone's right mind would want to just go, hey, the simpler path would make sense. Why should I, you know, put so much effort into a lost cause? I could understand that. Well, I don't think that's the right thing to do. Honestly, I don't. I think that is completely the wrong thing for them to do, because if they don't do it, no one else will. So I'm so glad that they're sticking to their guns. They're sticking to, you know, Ruby's whole leadership's, you know, morale, just, you know, continue to press them forward. It's just so beautiful to see, you know, and I'm super excited that they haven't just thought, hey, this is, you know, maybe we should just do this instead, you know, not press forward. Like, you know, Crow is kind of, on the most part, the most apathetic of all at this point. He's kind of given up all hope. He doesn't want to continue anymore. He's just kind of like, I'm done with this. Now, at this stage, he's getting more drunk. He's just in this funk, and it's hard to pull out of those kind of funks. I've been in those funks. I know a lot of us have, that we just don't want to keep going, especially when it's, you know, things are on the line, because it's so hard to do. And that's the beauty of this story. I'm so glad that they're putting this in there, that the beauty of this particular season seems like that while things look grim, things look bleak, and things, you know, there are alternate paths that are easier, that we're going to continue on this hard path no matter what, because we do it because of the people that we've lost. We do it for the people that we care about, and we do it because of the people that we're with. And that speaks volumes to this. I just wanted to say that. This is beautiful. I am super... This season is slowly starting to build in my ranking very quickly. I don't know what about you guys and gals. We have only seen, you know, so many episodes so far, but we're almost done. I think it ends at the beginning of February, at the end of this month, so we're almost done with Ruby. So not Ruby in general, just Ruby this volume. So I'm just kind of curious of what they do. So guys and gals, let me know what your thoughts are. Let me know what your theories are. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button down below. And I'll see you probably tomorrow with something special, hopefully, if you like that. Peace out. Shabam. A special thank you to all my patrons. Thank you so much for your support.